All right, ladies and gentlemen, today the task before us is this Amtrol. I think it's the SX-9V floor mounted hydronic thermal expansion tank. It supports both these Weil-McLain boilers. The heating of these two indirects and all of these zones. And we have high pressure on both boilers. That expansion tank is full. I got the replacement. We're gonna do some a little bit of maintenance on the Weil-McLain, changing out the neutralizer media. So stick around, you're gonna love this video. Make sure you smash that thumbs up button and subscribe if you haven't done so already. All right, both boilers are off. My expansion tank is isolated. I got a garden hose hooked up to the drain, and the garden hose is going into a sump pump on the floor here, which services the two floor drains in the boiler room. Crazy, huh? Pretty cool. What's pretty cool is the amount of time and planning that went into this boiler room. The individuals are truly masters of their craft. Unfortunately, I have no idea who that person or persons are, but good job, guys. Good job. Now, to accelerate the draining process of this tank, I'm gonna use the Milwaukee M12 inflator. And that's gonna help push out the air out of the bladder of the tank. All right, once the tank was drained, I cut the 3/4 inch pipe and then removed the 1¼ by 3/4 male adapter and the associated tubing and fittings and valve. I guess they've done this a few times, huh? Using a wire brush, cleaned off the threads. We're gonna wrap this with some new Teflon tape and connect it to the bottom of the new expansion tank. 6 wraps with the PTFE tape. Connect that to the bottom. Let's catch it. There we go. Beautiful. Excellent. Let me get a wrench and tighten that up. All right, I have a 3/4 inch press coupling here. I marked the proper depth. I'm gonna manhandle this beast, set it right there. Okay. Beautiful. Excellent. All right, now since we have a fairly large system, the pre-charge of 12 is probably insufficient. Let's attach our, and we're at 10.5. Let's make this 15 PSI. Let's pump up the expansion tank to 15 PSI. I'm getting her ready for the system. Slowly open the valve, and now the expansion tank is one with the system.
I know what some of you are thinking in your head. Mikey Pipes, why did you install that SX-90V, and why didn't you put in like an extra number 60? Or even a 90? That's a great question. And My response to that is RTFM. But also, a direct replacement is sometimes the easiest alternative to minimize the cost of the job. If you read page 6 of the Amtrol guide on installing and sizing expansion tanks, the SX series, the 90, can give me a net BTU output of about 950,000 BTUs. That's pretty impressive. That is very, very impressive. Do I need 950,000 BTUs of expansion tank available to me with that 45-gallon capacity? No. I have two boilers that are 230,000 and 299,000 BTUs each. It's a little over 500,000 BTUs. I could have gotten away with the SX-40, right? But we went with the direct replacement because we had everything lined up, and only thing I needed was 1 3/4 inch Vega press coupling. Thank you for watching. Smash that thumbs up button. Catch you in the next one.